Alright, hi everyone, welcome to the stream.
Hello.
Just gonna advertise it on Facebook really quickly. Hi Alex, how are you doing?
I'm good, I'm excited for this match.
Me too.
The PVT that we have on our hand in the advanced bracket of our tournament. And I think this will be a fairly even matchup, I think.
Yeah, definitely. We can see that Nightowl or Philip has trained quite a bit here since he's in the gold division right now. Yeah.
Okay. And he has I think this season about 120 games played or something like that, and about 50% win rate. So fairly good. James,
indeed.
On the other hand, as we can see, not having practiced that much, but he was fairly good in previous games in the tournament, so
we'll
just see what he's going to bring into this match.
Yeah, it should be fairly balanced. And this is not the game that was supposed to happen today, actually, since we're supposed to have Eugene against Philip, but Eugene couldn't make it, so James will jump in here so we can have a game.
Yeah,
or one more game. So let's introduce the players here. In the top right position of the map, we have the green Protoss. It's James.
And in the top left position of the map, we've got our yellow Terran, and it's Philip.
Yay! So good luck to both of them. And so PVT is the matchup. Habitation Station is the map. Really interesting map. Of course, it has the gold base. It's the only map, I think, in the map pool that has the gold base. At least in the ladder map pool. I don't know, in the golden bark map pool, I don't know. Might be another one.
Yeah, I think you're right. And it's really nice, you could take this as either a quick second, if you want to be a bit greedy, or as a third. It has its advantages, but it also has some disadvantages.
Yeah.
For example, say if Philip goes for some tanks, he can siege on the Xel'Naga watchtower and just basically shoot up into the gold. And
into
it's really
the
hard.
Line,
for
yeah, that's right.
Yeah. And it's really hard for Protoss to break that.
So it is a bit. Yeah, and it's a bit exposed. It is clearly a bit risky to take the gold base.
Yeah.
So let's see if any of the players will go for it. Or if they will go for the safe options indeed, instead. Where's James going? Yeah, James is scouting the top lower left position. Or might be some proxy pile? No, I think he was just scouting in the wrong direction, no?
I think so too.
Yeah.
And he's going to the right hand, bottom right base as well. So he's not aware that this is a two-player map. where the positions are top left and top right. Unfortunate for him. But we're gonna see that there's a Reaper out or coming out for James right now, for Philip right now. And that's gonna be the scouting tool, or main scouting tool for Philip.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
As well as the SCV, which is patrolling the main.
Oh, yeah. And what's the SCV doing there? Do you have an idea why this SCV is patrolling there?
You might just want to patrol for some early, very early tech. Usually, if you send an SCV like that, it could be for an engineering or an eBay block on the natural. But as James did get the Zealot, and he is gonna get. A Stalker as a follow-up, that engineering bay block wouldn't do too much. But of course, now we have the Reaper in the base, and he can get some kills.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And one already. Second is about
two.
Far.
He needs to move that Stalker to take down that Reaper. Already three kills. That's already well done by that Reaper.
Yeah. That's definitely worth it, and the Reaper will fall eventually. And it's proof that you were right. It actually needs four shots to kill a probe here. So yeah, well done. I thought it was less than that.
Yeah.
But yeah, definitely need four shots. We have Stim being researched here. And for the Terran player. He's building
You've got
marauders.
some marauders in production, so very interesting choice here. Guess he wants to go for a heavy ground army. It's very risky though if the opponent is going Stargate, since you won't have the marine count actually to defer the oracle.
Definitely. But we don't see an oracle here so far. We see an expansion for both players actually, and both seem to go for the. Actually, we don't know for the Terran. He might go for the gold. He might just fly over the command center to the gold, or to his. No, he's building a bunker. Sorry, on the on his natural. So I guess he's gonna do for that. And we
He's
have a
using a
scan.
scan, which is nice, that he's the forge and extra gateway.
Two
He would,
gases.
at this time, there should already have been some tech for James, and maybe Philip will expect that there's some hidden tech, which is not the case, but it all depends. Or maybe Ziggy will bark in
Sorry
the
about this, guys. We have
background.
a yeah. We are minding I'm minding your little Ziggy here. And yeah. Sorry w if he's barking from time to time.
Yeah, so the robotic space, the tech choice for James here, which is definitely a fairly safe choice. With that forge, usually goes hand in hand for some macro-oriented play. Probably wants to go into Colossus fairly soon, take a third as well.
Chrono boosting the plus one here while the Terran has a 1-1 on the way. But with the Chrono boost, yeah, James should be able to catch up, although he's only one forge against the double evolution champ engineering bay, sorry, for the Terran player. So yeah, so basically Philip should be ahead in upgrades here.
Fairly soon, definitely. Of course, we see Philip adding on two additional barracks right now. Definitely very bio-heavy play. The factory's finishing up right now as well, so he's gonna probably put down the starport straight after. Would be interesting to see what goes on. Okay, it's a reactor on the factory, so that's probably for the medivacs.
Okay, and we do have a slight SCV advantage for James here, so 36 SCVs to 29 probes. So that's very good for a Terran. Usually
That's
the Protoss should
extremely
be
good for him.
behind. Yeah, Protoss should be ahead in workers with the Chrono boost, of course.
Philip just scanned the natural of James there. He saw the saturation was not so big on the natural. The army wasn't there in that position. Maybe he is going to draw some conclusions from it. Maybe he will attack, or maybe. Let's see what he will do anyway.
Yeah, I think
Oh.
he could risk in a little attack here. But we have a an observer in the main base of Philip, sorry. So Proto's gonna see everything here. He sees two tech labs being produced on the barracks and a lot of reactor barracks as well. But we do have more tech labs than reactors, so a very marauder heavy. Although right now we have more marines, definitely more marines than marauders, but this might change. And we have
And
a
we
comp.
actually have a second robotics facility being built now for James. And I actually like that choice because if the Terran goes so tech lab heavy, like meaning Marauder heavy, then you can get a couple of Immortals in the mix as well, and they really do some wonders against them.
But maybe he will be just he just wants to have a lot of Colossi here.
Could be true.
He's chrono boosting his Terminal Lance upgrade as well, so he's gonna have that going. And Colossi are on their way. For now we have, oh, it's the first one actually being produced, so it's gonna pop
And
in a
this is
second.
nice timing for Philip actually. Okay, one Colossus will be out to deal with this. Where's the Mothership core actually? Is there a Mothership core?
I'm not sure.
There's no Mothership core, so no Photon Overcharge available. There is gonna be a drop into the main, just with two Medivacs. He could snipe
Oh,
this
and the
Colossus.
Colossus will gonna be sniped immediately here. No reaction from James just yet, and the Colossus is gonna die.
Nice. Yeah.
And he's going for the engineering bay. No, sorry. Robotics bay.
Robotics bay.
And snipe start as well. Very nice here, so...
But no, he does lose all his all of his army for one Colossus and the tech. But of course, the one Colossus was already in production, so that's gonna come out right now. I'm not sure about that trade, actually. He lost a lot for this.
Yeah, but he's still in the supply lead, so I think I think it was worth it for him since he has a lot of production behind this, and he's catching up already in the supply.
Yeah, now we see double Immortals being produced since he has no choice but to produce them and not the Colossi. Second starport for James as well. That's going to be very good for some Vikings later on.
But they're not going to be so good against Immortals for now. And we have to see if actually the robotics facility will be produced once again, or if he's just going to stay on Immortals.
Yeah.
On there it is, robotics bay once again in the production tab.
I like, well, it's very risky, this third base of James, but of course the longer the game goes on, the better it is for him. There is third command center also in production for Philip there, but a bit behind, and it's gonna just take some time to complete and fly over. Meanwhile, 2-2 finished and 3-3 started already for Philip. This is a huge advantage for him.
That is a huge advantage, yeah. And the Protoss player is still on +1/+1, so...
Yeah, and 2-2 not even started for him.
Yeah. So yeah, definitely a big advantage for the Terran player here.
Once the 3-3 finishes, I can definitely see a game-deciding move, possibly, a game,
for
from
the Terran. Definitely. Yeah, nice +3/+3 timing. Would definitely be nice.
But at the moment, okay, only three Vikings. He does have a lot of Stalkers to focus down those Vikings. But only one Colossus. Nice split there, actually, from Philip. But unfortunately, James goes down the other way.
Yeah, a lot of Zealots as well. Do they have charge? No, they do not. Charge is definitely one thing you would like to have here, and it looks like we're gonna see our first engagement. He's actually he's going from behind, and nice force fields here, although the Zealots in that case they can't really close up to the Terran army, so the Colossus is already dead, and all the Protoss army is dying here. Actually, I think these force fields, they were working in favor of the Terran.
Definitely. None of the Vikings actually died, meaning that they will move on to live and fight those... nice drop, by the way. Completely missed that. Drop in the main, taking out a lot of Harvesters. Well, 9 or so killed.
There's only one Marine remaining. And yeah, definitely nice drop here. So a lot of the Harvesters have died. And the main army is just moving into the natural right now. And Natural is going to fall here in seconds to the Stim Marines and Marauders here. Down it goes, and which means...
It's that James 30 to 90 army supply. Yeah. This is looking very dire for James. And 3-3 is also about to finish any second now, so this...
This game goes definitely to James here. GG, well played. And
Well played indeed.
Yeah, well played for... Well played for Philip here, playing, quite defensively, but definitely he showed that his macro was superior in this game, I guess, and with the upgrades and everything, even the army supply.
The upgrades really made a big difference, and the drops killing that one Colossus and sniping the robotics facility really helped him, of course, as well. Yeah, I really like that play from him. Also, I like the fact that he was even thinking one step ahead as well. He had the ghost facility finished and was even getting cloak for the ghosts. So, yeah, even anticipating some High Templar transition.
Very good. Okay, so the next map is going to be Aquilon here. So I'm going to go ahead and create that. Aquilon Wastes, there it is. And we're gonna go straight into map number 2 here. So, yeah, let's see. I'm gonna invite our players. Oh, Frederick is there as well. And I think we're ready to go into the game number 2 here.
How is this team 1, 2 players?
Oops. okay, guys.
How does that even happen? On Aquilon Waste as well, you know.
Okay, so...
Is this the Blizzard version? Oh, it is, yeah. Okay.
Is it?
Sorry,
I'm
yeah.
not sure. Might be the version where you have double mineral and half the gas. Or where the mineral patches move. That would be funny.
Actually, I think it would be nice to try out that GameHard Observer interface and the GameHard extension.
Oh, yeah.
Like in IEM and stuff like that.
Yeah. Good.
Like, I'm using the GameHard extension. Not the extension, the Observer interface at the moment, and it's always like... much cleaner, I think. Anyway, in the top left corner of the map, we've got our orange Terran this time in the lead, 1-0. It's James.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, no, Philip.
And in the bottom right corner of the map, we have our green Protoss. It's James.
Yeah.
And Philip doesn't have the golden bug here. So he's not in the... Is he in the clan yet? Or maybe he has just disabled the icon? Could be.
I thought he was, yeah. Hmm. Oh no, he's not, because otherwise the tag would be on his name.
But you can... Oh. Ah, yeah. Okay, so maybe
the
I
clan tag.
Invite him again. Maybe he... So anyway, map number 2, Aquilon Flats here. Nice map for Protoss. Would you say?
In this matchup, I think it's much better for Terran.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because... just because of the way the bases are. Terran, of course, can easily take 3 bases and defend nicely. Mm-hmm. You could say this is the same for Protoss, but not really, because of the triangle position, which means that it's easy to drop from the third into the main. And it's harder for Protoss to walk this long distance. So what you want to do is Protoss is take a straight line of expansions.
Mm-hmm.
So it take the top expansion
this one, yeah,
instead
okay.
of the one with rocks. But like that's really well, it can be kind of difficult to defend if the Terran gets like tanks and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Sieges in the high ground, controls the space in between the two, and so on. So yeah it all depends.
Okay, if you have a scout on both sides here, and I like this from Night Owl, he's blocking the scout off with like an unfinished supply depot here that he just resumes building right now. So very nice here play from him, denying the scouting into the scouting formation completely. And James is going for a sneaky pylon in the natural of right in the natural of Philip here.
Oh, that's and he has full energy on his Nexus. As soon as the Cybercore is finished, he could choose to go for like a 4-gate.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, he was supply blocked there for a long time, but let's see where he will
Yeah,
Who
and
is, yeah, there we go.
he's chrono boosting that, yeah, definitely. But the SCV sees it, and I think Philip should smell that something is a bit fishy here.
Yeah, he could go for quick factory, widow mines, really nice to defend this, but he is like going for double reapers actually.
Double Reaper, wow.
Yeah, adding on one extra barrack only. Not
And
sure I like
a
this.
command center. Yeah, this is definitely. I
Look at
don't
where the extra gates are actually at the proxy pylon.
know. That's pretty cool, I have to say. And Warner tows his pylon to power them.
What happened to... Oh.
So the two Reapers are on the way. They're
They will
gonna
meet that stalker.
meet the Skulker,
Oh.
but both of the units were on a move
Oh.
command here, so no shots were fired. And Warp Gate research is about to
Now
finish.
Philip should see that pylon there, so this should ring alarm bells for him.
Yeah.
He's getting more and more Reapers actually, which I feel are not a very good choice against
Yeah.
the stalkers that are gonna come out fairly soon.
But the two Reapers in the main base doing a lot of damage to the probes, and there's no units to defend this, so he's taking a lot of damage. The two Reapers are killing the pylon on the top base.
He needs to react now, those Reapers are surrounded, and well, they have done their damage actually. And they even get away!
They get away with it. Oh no. And they do have done their damage indeed. The warping occurs, but
11
an
probes killed in
offensive force.
total.
Yeah. But now James Philip has to defend here. And without the he's building one marauder, that's really good. He will really need that marauder actually if he wants to defend here, because Reapers are not gonna cut it. And now the units actually powered their way through in the main base,
He needs to pull
and
those
he needs
SCVs,
to
so
pull
nice job was
SCVs.
in there. The two
And
Marauders just been in the back for a second, they're not in the
yeah.
fight, but they're coming now. He really needs them,
I
yeah.
think
And he needs to continue the production.
these two marauders plus the SCVs should be enough here. If James cannot warp in more, because he has no
Oh.
probes at home. The two probes
But
at home
look,
he
he
has
didn't
are
do
not.
anything with this.
Oh, the
He wasn't able to
marauders.
do much with this, yeah.
Oh, the marauders are not fighting, and there's two more though. He's nice from James. He's focusing down one marauder. This is. He's focusing down the second, and a lot of
Oh,
SCVs are
this
dying
looks...
here. It looks good for
Yeah.
James, and we have a GG.
Oh my
Nice.
god.
James
I
takes the
really
second
thought
game.
Philip would have this, but
Yeah, with all
well,
the
yeah.
damage he did with the Reapers in the first place, I thought that was his game really. And then, yeah, I don't know. Just the micro. I think if he had microed like a little bit better at the defense of the foregate, that many
Yeah.
SCVs with just two marauders should have been able to clean the stalkers.
Definitely,
And
and he shouldn't let the stalkers kite
yeah.
so much. Like that's all the time was spent not mining, and it also means that he was probably not producing actually continuously on his barracks, I think.
Okay. Heavy rain is map number 3 here. Heavy rain, heavy rain.
Oh, James is saying he can't win macro. So this
Ah.
could give an indication now. Or it could be a mind game actually, depends. But yeah. What does Philip think of that? Will he expect some pressure now, or will he
Yeah.
think, oh, he's gonna bluff?
Yeah, maybe it could be some mind games here. But I think just watching at game number 1, I felt that Philip was the better macro player.
Yeah.
So he might be just honest here, and but it might be a bluff as well. You never know. And
What's
same.
this team wanting again?
Yeah, I don't know what's happening. What's happening? Okay. Should be ready to go now. go, yeah.
Go, go.
Just need from James to answer as well. James, typo.
Pulled versus Rain 2-2. Oh my god. That's another brilliant TVP.
I need to see the...
The Jadon games?
Yeah, the Jadon games, definitely. So that's the last... Is that semi-final already, or is it still...
Yeah.
Okay.
Semi-final.
So, and then it's gonna be... Jadon against the winner of this, right?
No, well, it's gonna be Jadon against Hero, and then it's gonna
be... Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, so in the bottom position of Heavy Rain, we have our green Protoss, it's James.
Yeah, and in the top position of the map, we've got our orange Terran, and it's Philip.
So good luck to both players. So it's 1-1. So both of these players have to win the next map in order to win this best of three. And yeah, I'm really curious what we're gonna see. My guess would be James going for a four gate once again, just because it worked
could
for him
be.
The last game.
Yeah,
and
could be.
And as he said that he can't play macro game as well. He said that, so maybe a four gate. What do you think?
Yeah, could be something sneaky as well. Maybe some VTs or something like that. Would be interesting to see. Yeah, we're all gonna see the first indication of what he's planning with the way he takes his gases and also the way he's spending in Chrono Boost. And as we can see again, he's not spending his Chrono Boost. So this it seems to indicate four gate again.
Yeah, probably. As a Protoss player, would you not even spend the first Chrono Boost? Would you not spend at least one on the probes?
You would spend four. No, you spend two Chrono Boosts
on the probes.
Probes.
Oh yeah.
And then you've got about four Chrono Boosts over the duration of the of the Cybercore.
Okay, so the SCV is scouting this once again. Cybernetics Core is on the way. What do we have for the Terran? We have the Wolof once again. This time the probe managed to get in. And it's chased by an SCV and lost all his shields already. Yeah, this probe, if it moves too much like this, a pylon! We wanted to build a pylon in the middle base, but got denied by Philip here. Nice play.
Well, not really like the pylon would have done much, actually.
No.
But,
would have denied some mining time, because the SCVs would have to focus it or something.
Yeah. And actually already we have a situation where, because he's not chrono boosting, we can see that Philip is already ahead in SCVs, or in worker. Which really normally shouldn't be the case, as we said earlier. Protoss should always be ahead in workers.
Yeah.
But we see the double Reaper again, the reacted Reapers from the barracks.
Well, it worked very well last game, the first part of it.
Yeah, and this time Philip should definitely see that Chrono Boost on the Cybernetic score, so he should expect something like this. But he is doing the exact same build as in the last game, getting the command center now. He will probably follow up with two barracks, but will they be too late? And he's getting two additional Reapers now.
So are both of the players doing the exact same build right now?
It looks like it, but there are the gateways missing. Oh, they are being added on now. So two more.
Two more, and we don't have a proxy pylon. And the two Reapers are on their way, and they're gonna kill the probes once again.
The Stalker
is moving in the wrong direction. What's the Stalker doing? He needs to defend. And a lot of probes dying here. Four already. And now he's moving back.
Much better now for Philip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we don't have a proxy pylon on the way. And actually... There's two more Reapers here following up. So there's gonna be four.
And four Reapers can actually take it on the Stalker, I
Yeah,
think.
definitely. I think so. And then kite the Zealot to death as well. One more Stalker being morphed in. And the Stalkers are actually moving away. They have to. Ooh, the probe's being pulled here, like pulled back. And only one
And with
Stalker
this, he
attacking.
can actually one-shot the probes. Well, usually he can, I think. If they all fight the same. One Reaper will get taken out though, but the Stalker looks like it could get taken out. But no, Philip decides to back out for the moment.
Okay, this was a lot of damage done to the SCV line. If you compare now, we have 15 to 23.
There's a sneaky robotics though, like it's finished up now already. He could go for some immortals maybe, or willy tech, I'm not sure. It's very difficult to say what the best option is in the position that James is in now. Oh, three bunkers gonna be added into the choke of the natural. So Philip definitely expecting some aggression.
Yeah, he wants to be safe here. And Robux, we have a robotics facility built at the where the natural is supposed to be. And but nothing produced just yet. Maybe an observer?
Immortal coming out now. Well, one of the options he would have is like to build two or three immortals, walk across the map, and try and break the front. But if he does that, he leaves his main open, and the Reapers can come in and kill a lot of probes again. So it's very difficult to even do something that is the right choice right now.
Nice Reaper pressure by Philip, definitely. He's keeping James on the defensive here. And the Stalker's running back up, chased by one Reaper. Really? Okay, that is cool. And both of these Reapers are gonna die here. Nice. James cleaning up the Reapers, so these are not a threat anymore. And Immortals being chrono boosted out.
And of course, now we have the situation where map control can be in the favor of the Protoss once again. But I mean, look at the bunkers down the front. We've got the three bunkers and two supply depots doing a nice defense there. So even if James would decide to walk across the map, Philip is more than prepared.
Definitely. And no second base for James just yet. I feel like so second Colossus is there. Maybe he was waiting for the second Colossus and will make his move. Or else he would probably need to expand soon. Because a nice scan here by Philip. Seeing the army count, the exact army count, and sees also that there's no nexus here. And he saw the probe as well. And did he see? I don't know if he saw in the end the direction the probe took. If he saw that the probe was moving out of the base, or maybe he could thought that the probe was just going down for to build a nexus. So, but the probe is definitely building a proxy pylon here, and James will go for the aggression. And as you said, with that many bunkers, it's a
The
little bit
bunkers are not
dicey.
filled though at the moment, and actually one of the bunkers is in a fairly bad position, just being outside a lot. And even if SCVs would wanted to come and repair it, it's really far away. So yeah, James can still make this happen. Three immortals, very strong against bunkers, very strong against marauders.
The bunker's being manned. The first one, as you said, very exposed, is about to fall. Second bunker is dying as well. Here comes the stim. Two medivacs joining the fight right at the moment. Nice force fields here.
He wants to get that immortal. Second one dies. There's one immortal left. Just a couple of stalkers left now, and one immortal which will also die through the bunker probably. There we go. And this looks very nice for Philip now.
Just the third bunker was the one to prevail. Also being repaired. Nice stop on the repair now. And Philip holds and has a huge advantage in this game, since that was kind of, as there's no second base behind this, this was kind of an all-in attack. And Philip with the second command center is like miles ahead in this game, and he's going for the drop now.
I mean, we have 10 army supply against 43, so even with the drop there, With Stim, he can chase down those stalkers, and the marauders will just make short work of them.
No concussive shells just yet, so he's not gonna.
Stalkers are very fast.
Yeah, but if you slow them with concussion, can't say that.
Yeah. Concussive shells.
Yeah, thank you. You should be able to catch, get them, kill them.
And there's no answer to the double medivac trap in the main, so this looks like Philip will take the game any second now.
Yeah. Yeah, nothing here to defend, as you said. There's three Stalkers and one Immortal coming up the ramp, but and a couple of Zealots. But I feel like this unit should be able to deal with whatever with what James has at home. And yeah, it looks like the game's gonna be over this drop here. One Immortal falls, two more Stalkers, and this has to be GG. James is not mining. GG, well played. Nice games. Nice games indeed.
And very well played indeed, actually, from Philip.
Yeah. Philip takes the series 2-1. Congratulations to him. So, we should have a second match today. It's actually you, Alex, against Andre.
Yeah. I think that's going to happen straight after this.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fine with me. I don't really have a co-caster, I think. But
you can ask one of the guys.
Yeah.
So I think in the rankings for the tournament right now, I think both were on equal stats. I think 1 and 3 or 1 and 4, something like that. So this means that they were essentially fighting for the next spot up, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah.
So should we go straight into the next match then? Just checking out what's the map here. It's Whirlwind. So
they already left, I think.
I'm just gonna stop the stream here, and then I will gonna start it again. So if you're watching the stream right now, it will start again in a few minutes, and then we go on with the next game. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and see you in a few minutes.
See you guys.